on that, so about 1 p.m. Eastern time
yep.
zone, depending on how long that top 24 takes itself or finishes up. And, of course, top 8 is 3 out of 5.
Yes, and we're going to be there for a while, so I hope you guys are ready for some intense Dead or Alive 6 action, guys. Again, there's a lot of players that you guys are not going to get to see today, unfortunately, because we're going to be ending here shortly as far as the stream portion goes. But you guys can check Facebook. I'm going to try to post any pools updates that I can on the Facebook competitive group. Again, shout-outs to the competitive Dead or Alive group as well. You know, back in DOA 5, that was the number one source for, obviously, Freestep guys as well. Those are the two number one sources for keeping up with the game. So be sure to join that competitive group if you guys are on Facebook and you want to keep up with the players in a more interactive environment.
And the official name of that group is?
Competitive Dead or Alive group. You can actually search it up and find it.
Yep.
Thousands of members that are in there, guys. Be sure to check that out.
Yep. And, of course, you can go to freestepdodge.com as well. Shout out to Matt.
Shout out to Matt.
For hosting that site for the last decade now.
Yeah. So and before that, it was DOA Central, too.
Exactly.
So, yeah, man, it's been a crazy journey, man, but it's just really awesome. Again, I keep saying it's awesome to be at CEL. It's awesome to have Dead or Alive 6 here for the first time. It really is a great feeling to be out in Florida for this game.
Yeah. Shout out to our sponsor, also Samsung.
Yeah, definitely.
So.
So, you know, and there's a lot of players here, guys. We got Blackberry Chaos, you guys. You know, he just came off his second place placing at Final Round as well as April Annihilation. So
yep.
he's been doing really well so far. He's actually looking to take this. We got Hoodless here. We got Quiggle. We got Excalibur Blades.
Events, by the way, for April Annihilation.
Crazy steady one Final Round, and April Annihilation was Excalibur Blades.
Nice, nice, nice.
So Excalibur Blades is here as well. We got Rakuto here somewhere. So it's going to be an awesome weekend, guys.
Yep.
So Dolphish immediately starting off the round with the 6-6K into the Gutham, which they made unsafe in this game.
Yeah, for sure. And it's a Tina Mir.
Ooh, Tina Mir. I didn't even see the other character.
Right. Oh, is he going to finish his full throw? That's disrespectful. I was about to say, break out of that.
I mean, I haven't seen Team Chris play yet, but I mean, if he made it this far, he obviously knows what he's doing, so let's see what's going to happen.
He's got some superior.
Is he going to be the superior Tina? That was crazy. All right, he's going to take that break blow.
Yeah, so you always, like a mirror match, you kind of always take a little bit more personal, right?
Oh, yeah, 100%. I cannot stand when people try to pick Hayato.
Yeah,
leave
you
him on.
You just want to put him in the ground real quick.
I don't like it. I don't like it.
So I think Team Chris is looking to do the same thing. He's starting off really strong in these first two rounds.
Right.
Nice recognizing. He stunned him. He said, I know you're going to hold. Let me throw you. Take this round. Done. I like it. Punch, kick, grab, and those are staples from DOA. You know, just put something on the screen, put them in block stun, grab.
Ooh.
The one thing you don't want to do with Dogfish is because you sleep on him because he loves using that 4K.
Right.
So he's getting that deep stun. He likes doing that throw immediately afterwards.
So right now we're seeing a lot of, you know, kind of just like general Tina stuff. We're seeing a lot of bad people's K to jump over to low wake up here. We're seeing, like, you know, obviously two solid Tina players going at it right now. So so Dogfish gets a point on the board. Let's see if he can capitalize, maybe finish out this game. Gets the Fatal Stun. One thing that I haven't seen Team Chris take advantage of, but Dogfish is aware of, is the up punch for the Fatal Stun.
And another thing that we need to recognize with Team Chris, he's got to pay attention to Dogfish on that 4K, that jumping mid-K.
Oh, yeah.
Because every time he's gotten it successfully and stunned him, he's grabbed. So he's just got to recognize
the grab. Thank God that her back kick does not stun him.
Right.
That was crazy.
Right. Too dangerous. Too dangerous.
Oh, my God. His head's going to hit the wall, too. Jeez. Whoa.
Nice flip over a mid-kick.
Dude, what happened to
nice
that? I thought I was watching a Jackie Chan movie. He just flipped over a mid. Like, literally, a kick went through her body. That
and
was
he
crazy.
Said, I knew that was going to happen.
Team
Nothing
Chris,
to see here.
He was like, I've practiced that never, but it worked. And I just
Nothing
knew it was
going to
happen.
Here.
That was crazy. All right. So, Dogfish, I mean, you know, he's trying to stay in this right now, man. But I think that he met his maker here. I mean,
yeah.
Team Chris is looking really good right now with Tina. And, you know, again, I hope they get together afterwards. Obviously, them both being Tina players, hope they get together and share notes or whatever, share some tech, and, you know, obviously help each other out and get better at the game. So that'd be cool.
Or Team Chris is going to say, you know what? I don't want you.
You're on your own.
You're on your own.
You're going to have to kick rocks this
time
around. I wouldn't help any Hayato player. As me.
All they got to do is go to YouTube and watch your videos.
Yeah, you're right. All right, here's the 4-4 kick. Nice. I love that Dogfish is using that bound.
Yeah. Strong stuff.
That's unsafe. No
there
punish there
again?
By Dogfish. Again.
4K to
it's
the
good.
Throw.
If you get hit by a back kick, you're in a gut stun. What are you going to do?
That's the fourth time we've seen it. That's the reason why he's taking the rounds. If he gets that each round, he's taking it. So much damage he gets from it. There it is again. crazy. But this time, Chris did not choose the hold.
So he didn't get the high counter damage. But either way, nice hold there. Mid-kick hold there by Dogfish. Tina actually has access to an advanced mid-kick hold, too. Ooh, that was good.
That is great strength recognition.
Yeah. That's how you know he knows his character. All right, that wasn't plus. So that booty bump is actually plus from tip range, or if you do it from like max, in that max area range, you actually get plus frame per block. Yep. He is, oh yeah, he's super dead. That does so much damage.
It's a crazy amount of damage. It's an extra like 20% that's getting attacked.
It does a lot, man. Plus you hit the wall, essentially, so you're getting that damage too. All right, that's unsafe, no punish. Generally, every fatal stun is gonna be unsafe.
Get that throw punch in, or you could try for strike punch.
Yeah.
In some cases.
All right, so he's going to take the back throw. Does he know about the guaranteed low throw? Oh, wait, what happened? He must have mistimed it, yep. Oh.
And that.
Catches him low hold and throws him right on his back.
That's a hard read.
Like, that was.
To do something like that's a hard read. He deserved that round.
Ooh. Ooh, Tina's sick.
I like what we're seeing from Dogfish there. Now he's starting to mix
nice.
It up.
Nice, he recognizes that offensive hold, though. And he got his own back turn throw of his own.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Team Chris is not trying to have this go to a third game.
Oh, no. He wants to end this. Wow.
Great read from Dogfish there.
Dude, he just read. Look at that smirk. Okay, he's up? Like, yeah, that's a kick you in your face. I don't care.
They've reversed now. Like, now he's smirking, and Team Chris is like, all right.
Yeah, Team Chris's hair is starting to right. – he's like, my hair drying up a little bit, man. I got to get out of here. I got to finish this. Look, he's looking at
salt.
It. He's like, damn, it's drying.
Too much salt. Rub his hands together.
Look
he's
at
like,
him.
I got to get this. I
is that
get
a Space
this.
Jam shirt?
No,
that's an NBA
Jam.
Jam. Okay.
Either way, that would have been dope if
it
had
it. It was, yeah. All right, so I don't know what's going to happen. I mean, it's 1-1. I don't know who's going to win.
I mean, whoever gets 4K throw first.
Yeah, exactly, because they won't. That's safe. All right, gets the half wall splat there.
That's a full combo. It takes about half life. And Team Chris right. Starting off pretty well.
Uh-huh.
And Smart recognized he just walked away from him so he didn't pop up attack.
So we did see a mix-up. We saw a back kick and a jab extension. We saw a mix-up. All right. Nice hold by Dolphish. He almost died. Ooh, okay. So that's another thing. Tina's 1K in this game is 0 on hit.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's 0 on hit. That's something to note for sure. It's a big change.
Yeah, and it was that way in D-Way 5.
Was it really?
But it was only fastest stagger.
Oh, okay, yeah, that's right. And again, they changed a lot of properties for moves because there is no stagger escape again, so you can't get out of these stunts. So what they did was, if something was too good to the point where you needed to actually stagger escape to get out of it, they made it so that it has less advantage.
Yep.
Oh my god, he actually caught him recovering.
Nice hold. Had to do that to stay alive.
Oh, gets the ground pound. So when you're in that situation, it's actually somewhat of a mind game because you might think that, oh, well, they think I'm going to back tech because I'm about to die. But they might actually just stay on the ground anyways and take the ground pound. So it's definitely an annoying mind game. Okay, catches the offensive hold there. He's going to hit the wall. That extra damage there. Nice. He's going to go for the low throw. No.
Guard break.
Ooh. Okay.
So in that situation, I'm not sure who should have won that throw. Maybe it's the stronger throw.
All right, he's going to hit. No wall again, but Team Chris didn't know life.
That was dangerous.
Okay, catches him. So, I'm the option there. He tried, but I would, in most cases, there. But
it really was a bit of a scramble there. Both something on the screen.
Ooh, so nice back turn throw there by Dogfish.
But I sure. And so, what we're seeing right now, looking pretty strong, looking like he's going to take this whole match.
All right, Dogfish again. One more mix up, and Team Chris can move on. Oh. If he gets a down throw, he's dead. Yep, and that is a dead Tina. Oh, now he's dead. Okay. Okay, you know what it was? They nerfed the damage on the. They nerfed the damage on it. So, Dogfish. Man, that was crazy. Honestly, better than I thought he was going to do. I did not. Expect him to do that well. So, no, either way, I mean, that was a good set.
I enjoyed it a lot. So, of course, guys, you know that we are closing up at 12 o'clock. So,